morning students. Chapter 1 Reproduction in Organisms. In today's class, we are going to see about the different phases of life cycle. Organisms have three different phases: juvenile phase, reproductive phase, and senescent phase. What is juvenile phase? In animals, we call it as juvenile phase, and in plants, we call it as vegetative phase. In animals, the juvenile phase is the period of growth between the birth of the individual up to reproductive maturity. So, it is a phase, or it is a period between the birth and reproductive maturity. Juvenile means young ones, so it is the younger phase. And in plants, it is called as vegetative phase. Why it is called as vegetative phase in plants means it is the interflowering period. The next phase is the reproductive phase or the maturity phase. During this phase, the organisms attain maturity, they reproduce and produce their offsprings, and their offsprings again reach the maturity. So, what is reproductive phase or maturity phase means? It is the period during which the organisms reproduce and their offsprings reach maturity period. On the basis of time, breeding animals are of two types. One is called as seasonal breeders, and the other one is called as continuous breeders. So, what is seasonal breeders means? Seasonal breeders reproduce at particular period of the year, such as frogs, lizards, moose, birds, deers, etc. So, these animals breed only during a particular period of the year. For example, the frogs usually breed during the rainy season. During rainy season, you can able to hear the croaking sound of frog. So it is a signal of the male frog to attract the female frog for breeding. So seasonal breeders reproduce only at a particular period or season. So they are called as seasonal breeders. And what are continuous breeders means? They continue to breed throughout their sexual maturity. So continuous breeders, they don't have any particular period for breeding. They continue to breed throughout the year or throughout the sexual maturity. Example, honeybees, poultry, rabbit, etc. So, based on the time of breeding, the animals are classified into two types. One is called as seasonal breeders and the other one is called as continuous breeders. Seasonal breeders breed only during a particular season, but the continuous breeders, they breed throughout the year or throughout the sexual maturity. The last phase is called as the senescent phase. So this phase begins at the end of reproductive phase when degeneration sets in the structure and functioning of the body. So the senescent phase is the final phase, or it is otherwise called as the death phase. It occurs or it starts at the end of the reproductive phase. So, during this senescent phase, it is otherwise called as aging phase, because the organisms or the animals aging process starts. So degeneration, that is deterioration, sets in the structure and functioning of the body. That is, the aging occurs in the organism. So this is called as the senescent phase. So the organisms have three phases of life cycle. Juvenile phase, it is the phase or it is the period of growth between birth of the individual up to the reproductive maturity. Next is the reproductive phase or maturity phase. During this phase, the organisms reproduce and produce their young ones. Those young ones reach maturity. Next is the senescent phase, or it is otherwise called as the death phase. It is the final phase. During this phase, the organisms attain aging process. Degeneration sets in the structure and functioning of the body. In plants also, you can able to see the three phases, that is the vegetative phase, reproductive phase and senescent phase. Next, we are going to see the topic parthenogenesis. Parthenos means virgin, genesis means produce. So it is commonly called as virgin birth. Why the name parthenogenesis means? In sexual reproduction, we have seen the male gamete, sperm, fertilizes the female gamete, ovum. The fertilized egg or the fertilized ovum is called as zygote. The zygote develops into a new organism. But in case of parthenogenesis, development of an egg into a complete individual without fertilization. So what is happening in case of parthenogenesis means, without fertilization, new organism or new individual develops from an egg. So it is called as parthenogenesis. So development of an egg into a complete individual without the act of fertilization is known as parthenogenesis. So it is also a form of asexual reproduction, because here no two parents are involved. It was first discovered by Charles Burnett in the year 1745. Parthenogenesis is of two main types, namely natural parthenogenesis and artificial parthenogenesis. What is natural parthenogenesis means? In certain animals, the parthenogenesis occurs regularly, constantly and naturally in their life cycle, and it is known as natural parthenogenesis. So here the parthenogenesis occur naturally, constantly and regularly in the life cycle of some organisms. So the name natural parthenogenesis. Now we'll see some different types of natural parthenogenesis. Erhenotoki. In this type, only males are produced by parthenogenesis. Examples, honeybees. Usually, if you take the parthenogenesis, they usually or commonly occurs in very lower plants and animals. So it occurs mainly in some lower invertebrates such as ants, wasps, honeybees, etc. So the name Erhenotoki means, here in this type only males are produced by parthenogenesis. Example, honeybees. Next is Theritoki. In this type only females are produced by parthenogenesis. Example, Solenobia. So in this type only the females are produced and no males are produced by this method. Next is the Amphitoki. In this type, parthenogenetic egg may develop into individuals of any sex, either male or female. So this is called as Amphitoki, example amphis. The natural parthenogenesis is mainly classified into two types. One is called as complete parthenogenesis and the another one is incomplete parthenogenesis. So what is complete parthenogenesis means? It is the only form of reproduction in certain animals and there is no biparental sexual reproduction. There are no male organisms and so such individuals are represented by females only. So why the name complete parthenogenesis means? It is the only method or it is the only form of reproduction in certain animals. So here there is no chance for biparental, that is two parents, sexual reproduction. And in this type only the male organisms are produced by parthenogenesis. Sorry, no male organisms are produced, only females are produced by this complete parthenogenesis. Next we are going to see about the incomplete parthenogenesis. Why the name incomplete parthenogenesis means? It is found in some animals in which both sexual reproduction and parthenogenesis occurs. So in the previous one, that is complete parthenogenesis, we have seen that it is the only method or form of reproduction. But in case of incomplete, here both sexual reproduction as well as parthenogenesis occurs. So it is incomplete parthenogenesis. Example is honeybees. In honeybees, the fertilized eggs, that is the zygote, develops into queen and workers. But the unfertilized eggs developed into drones, that is male. So it is called as incomplete parthenogenesis because here sexual reproduction also takes place. On the other hand, parthenogenesis also takes place. So it is a example of incomplete parthenogenesis, example honeybees. So in honeybees, we can able to see the fertilized eggs develop into queen and workers, but the unfertilized eggs develop into drones. In this picture, you can able to see the drones, which are otherwise called as males. They are produced through parthenogenesis. So they are haploid. But the workers or queens, they are produced from the fertilized eggs and they are diploid. So this is a good example of incomplete parthenogenesis. Next, we'll see about the pedogenetic parthenogenesis. It is otherwise called as pedogenesis. Here, the larva produces a new generation of larvae by parthenogenesis. So, why the name pedo means? Pedo means young ones are larvae. Here, the larvae produce a new generation of larvae by parthenogenesis. It occurs in the sporocyst and radii larvae of liver fluke. So liver fluke is a parasite. It is a parasite which lives in the intestine of human. So this pedogenetic parthenogenesis occurs in the, that is, sporocyst and radii larvae of liver fluke. It is also seen in the larvae of some insects, example gallfly. Next is the, so till this natural parthenogenesis, next we'll see about the artificial parthenogenesis. So in artificial parthenogenesis, the unfertilized egg or ovum is induced to develop into a complete individual by physical or chemical stimuli. So here the parthenogenesis does not occur naturally. It is called as artificial because here the parthenogenesis is induced due to some physical or chemical stimuli. So example, annelid and sea urchin eggs. So what is parthenogenesis means? Parthenogenesis is the development of an egg into a complete individual. Without fertilization. And the parthenogenesis is again classified into two main types. One is called as natural parthenogenesis and the another one is called as artificial parthenogenesis. Again, the natural parthenogenesis is of two types. One is called as complete parthenogenesis and the another one is called as incomplete parthenogenesis. So till this we conclude the topic and almost we have covered this chapter. So go through this topic. In the next class, we'll be starting with the new chapter. Thank you.